Do you want to send your record data from Airtable to make.com? It's as simple as installing a webhook, which will fire off an automation, which will send the record ID through to Airtable. You can change it for numerous different activities. I can change the status of here by clicking a checkbox. You'll see should fire the automation here. And we've got a few other examples. If I change the name of this record to record one, bring it back. Tell you what we'll do, we'll change it back to three. This will, again, cause another automation. So, bing. Okay, we can also do it inside of the interface. So if I click example four, run the automation, and it's fired off the webhook. And we can also do it by clicking a button inside of the table itself. So if I click run one more time, this button here will run the automation. You can see it's brought up the extension, webhook button, printing, running, and boom, it's gone away again. And then finally we have one more, which is if we go to our forms. I wasn't in the view mode. And we'll click submit. So if you'll join me on the after the introduction, I'll show you through the build. So we're going to start off inside of our normal workspace. So mine's Luminous AI workspace, and I'm going to create a new table. From here, we'll just make some fields basically. So name can stay as name. What we want to do is change this first one here to, we'll call this one check. And what we're going to do is change it to a checkbox. So checkbox. Okay, we'll change the to something else. We'll change it to description. And it can be long line. We'll swap it over. The status can remain the status. So, all well and good. But now what we need to do, we need to get stuff over to make.com. I'll quickly log in because my computer's a bit slow. Airtable, and we're going to go into the automation section. So basically there's this section in here where you can run automations, and what we need is a trigger. So basically when a condition, so these are some of the suggested triggers they have. So when a record matches a condition, when a form submitted, when a record's created, updated, at a scheduled time, or when a record enters a view. So I'm just going to show you a few from the example build that I showed you earlier. We'll go with when a record matches a condition. So we haven't named our base and we haven't named our table, so I expect this to say table one. Okay, and the condition, let's say when checkbox is checked, okay, then we will have an action. So the action is going to be, we don't want to send an email, create a record, update a record, find a record. What we want to do is run a script. And what we're going to do is, we don't want to say hello, or hello world, hello. We will delete that. And I'm going to, from my other screen, paste over. Don't worry, I'm going to attach all of the information from this in the description at the bottom of the video. So we have, basically we declare the record, input.config, so that as if you can see here, this is input.config, and then we're going to declare a variable, await, fetch, and then we have a webhook. Now this is from a different build, so I want to get rid of it just before the question mark. Okay, and we're going to come back to this. So now we're going to over to make.com. Let's go to our scenarios. Let's go to my YouTube build. I'm going to create new. And I'm going to select the webhook trigger module. So, as you can see here, we have custom mail hook, a custom webhook, and a webhook response. So, the one I want is a custom hook. And I'm going to create a new webhook. And we'll call this webhook build. Let's copy the webhook. So there's a convenient button there. We're going to go back to our table and we're going to paste it just before the question mark here. Okay, so I'll click finish editing for now. Go back to the data, do this later, and I'm going to check the box. We will now test the automation. So select a record. Now I have a record to choose from. So let's run the automation and let's run the webhook. Okay, hang on. Jump the gun a bit there. I'll press run. We'll go back and we will start a new test. Select the record, click run automation, and there we are, we've received the record ID. Very good. So next one will be get an Airtable record. We're going to need to create a new connection, so I can't use any of my existing. I'm going to have to add a new connection. Very simple, very easy to do. We go click on Airtable OAuth connection. We'll call this webhook build 2. Hopefully I'm going to get connection. I just had to reset the computer. Hey, okay, so we are working with untitled base. Very original. There we are, that's better. Okay, and did we name it? No, it's untitled base. Okay, and it's table 1. Okay, and the record ID is going to come from the webhook. So, why don't we run this again one more time? We'll go back to our automation. Hopefully everything is still peachy from before. We'll click on test. We'll select the record. And then, okay, and let's go to make.com. Okay, there we are. It's received the record ID, so we've got undefined though for some reason. So let's go back, make sure I haven't messed anything up. We'll go back, we'll get out of the test automation. I just want to check that this is all correct. We've passed a variable, that's why. So we need to add record ID equals, and we get the ID from when the record matches, so which record it came from. And then we're going to double check. So what I did there was I double clicked, and that selects everything up as far as the question mark. And then I'm just going to click for my own sanity. We'll go back, click OK, and we're going to click run one more time. Wait for new. Test. And that's better. See how we've got two ones inside of the spyglass, and it's brought back our record ID. So if we want to see what's inside, just check, says true. Okay, so the next one I want to build out is, it's really easy. Once you have one built, you can just keep duplicating. So I'll finish editing, I'll switch this on, and we'll call this one check. All we need to do is duplicate. So we don't need to paste the codes or anything, don't need to copy the webhook again. And we can just change the condition. So still from the same record, when a record matches a condition, table 1. And then we can put status equals to do. OK. So if I try and choose a record now, it won't give me any options. So let's go back, do this later, and let's change this to done, and we'll call this one status, just so we can identify them a bit better. Sorry, I'm a bit sick, so my typing is a bit off. And we'll call it status equals done, just so I can identify it when I show you at the other end. Let's go back to our automation now. And if you want to test, we'll click run again. Wait for new data. And let's choose a record to run a test. Now we have one not to choose from. Click run. Okay, excellent. So just to make sure that's correct, status equals done. There we are. So what else can I show you? Let's build ourselves a button inside of the table. So I need to add another field, and we need a button. Okay. And then this will be run a script yet again. So this will be webhook. And let's change the color to green because it's a button. Oh, we need to add the extension first. I always forget. So let's add the extension. Type in script. And I believe it's called scripting. That's correct. Add the extension. Okay, so get started, start from scratch. I'm going to delete the one that's there already and take from one that I built earlier, so bear with me one moment. I'm just going to copy and paste from the previous build, and if you remember the name of our table, it's Airtable Base, and we named the table Table 1. I didn't really rename it, so I'll just change that to table 1. And the webhook is for a previous build, so as again, press double clicked, and that's taken me as far as the question mark, so I want to preserve everything forward from there. We're going to go back to make.com, we're going to select the settings, we're going to copy the webhook again. And we're going to paste in here. And then, tell you what, let's click run. Use new. I don't know why we have two coming through. And let's pick a record. Let's select this one here. Okay, should have gone through. And finally, whilst the video was paused for a second, whilst the recording was paused, it came through. So we got status equals done. So I'm happy with everything so far. I just want to build one more. So this might be something new for some of you out there. But Airtable has this nifty thing called interfaces. I use them a lot for my clients because sometimes they don't have full access, so it's a good way to work around giving every new member having to pay $10, $12 per month, so you can build an interface for them and give them reader access and then paste in lots of forms, and that way they can do a data entry without doing any damage to the actual database. So we'll build an interface. We'll just call it interface quite easily, and we're just going to build from a blank template. Okay, and the first thing we want to select is what's called a record picker. We'll plonk it there, and then from the record picker I'm going to take the name, the description, and I'm going to add an element, and inside the element I'm going to, this element will be a button. We'll paste it here. Let's make it a little bit bigger. And then its action over here on the right hand side, what we want is, you'd never guess, we're going to run an automation. So we can select an automation, but we can't select these ones here. It has to be from the, you have to build a new one basically. So I'll say interface webhook, continue to the automation, and great thing about this is I can just copy it from here. So get out of test mode, edit the code, finish editing, and we'll go back here and you guessed it, run script. Only thing we need to remember to do is to pass in the record ID again, making sure it matches the same as we have typed here. If you want to change it to something else, say it's booking ID, customer ID, whatever you want, just make sure you label it the same there and it will be your record ID. So I know that's good, but let's go back one more time. Click run once, wait for new. It's playing up on me today. And let's go to our interface, do this later. Select a record. Status. It's not ready yet, is it? Turn on the automation. My bad. Turn it on. Go back. And trigger an automation. So, ready? There we are. Excellent. So, I'm going to spin round and return to my normal camera. So, yeah, I hope you enjoyed that. The only one I didn't do was when a form is filmed, but that's the same as when a condition is met. So, basically, when a form is filmed, you run the automation. So, hopefully, you've learned something from this video. Bit basic, but I think it's important to know the basics before we get into the really intricate builds. I might have rushed ahead with the start of this channel, but hopefully, yeah, if you've enjoyed the video, thumbs up, leave me a comment. I'm not getting much feedback and just throwing videos out there. I've been a bit sick, which is why I haven't posted for a week, but yeah, thanks, and I'll see you on the next video.